Over the years of Japan, both Godzilla and Ultraman
have many different monsters in their franchises.
Like giant mechs, aliens, evil counterparts, and even ripoffs of themselves. But these two monsters have the most strangest abilities in their franchises.
Orga, the mutated alien clone of Godzilla. And Bogarl, the high-dimensional predator. I'm Westby, and it's my job to see who would win a fight.
There's a lot of mystery things about space, like if there's more planets or universes, but what's more interesting, if there's other life out there. Well, we may not know in our world, but in this world, you will.
A group of aliens called Millenniums fled their own planet by a deformation, looking for a new empire. However, after they crashed onto the Pacific Ocean and was pretty much trapped over here for 60 million years, until it was awoken by the military, but after they discovered Godzilla and noticing his cells give him much more power and regeneration, they decided to copy him
and become the mutated alien clone of himself, Orga.
Weighing in 4,000 tons, Orga is shown to be one of Godzilla's most dangerous enemies.
He fights with his teeth, claws, but he usually fights his enemies with his most famous attack, the shoulder cannon. A powerful energy blast that comes out of Orga's right shoulder, which is strong enough to knock Godzilla.
And because of Godzilla's cells, he can regenerate large chunks of body flesh.
He can gain other creatures' DNA just by biting into their flesh.
Can jump 100 meters high in a total distance of 300 meters.
And can increase his mouth to consume prey.
He even can share a telepathic link with his UFO.
The UFO can control underground steel cables, creating little vine whips to drag down Godzilla.
Durable enough to survive Godzilla's atomic breath, and even took hits from Godzilla himself. And strong enough to even bring down Godzilla. And he can even fire an energy blast similar to Orga's shoulder cannon.
He's strong enough to fight on with Godzilla, and even push him off. And was not even harmed by Godzilla's teeth and claws, and survived shots from Godzilla's atomic ray.
However, despite being a clone of Godzilla, Orga is not perfect. He is slow and sluggish, needs to absorb a large amount of DNA in order to keep any new traits he gains, his regeneration is not perfect, enough damage could destroy his UFO, and he couldn't regenerate his shoulder cannon after it was destroyed by Godzilla.
Despite losing everything, Orga was determined to never give up, as he actually tried to even swallow Godzilla to become him. However, that ultimately backfired, as Godzilla literally just destroyed Orga from the inside. Kind of a strange death, but even then, this just proved that if Godzilla was not around, Orga would have actually just conquered the world, and the Millenniums would start their new empire.
Life is always unexpected. When you walk outside, you expect something new would happen. We always experience different things in our world, but in this world, you would witness giant monsters flying and some trying to take over the world.
But you also notice a woman. Well, she may look ordinary, you would notice that she has strange powers and a taste for monsters. This is no ordinary girl. This is the predatory monster that likes to eat other monsters, called Bogarl.
Now, Bogarl doesn't exactly have an origin story, but what I do know is that she was responsible for the Emperor's return, and responsible for summoning several monsters to her, such as Solida and Twintail. She's strong enough to push heavy monsters around, and even lift monsters with her tail, even while fighting them.
She can keep up with Ultraman Hikari and Ultraman Mebius in battle,
who are both around Mach 2 and Mach 2.5 in running speed. She can fire purple energy blasts from her hands and her back.
She can increase her tail to even trap enemies or hold enemies, and even electrocute them.
And can also breathe underwater. She can also use her psychic abilities to control her opponents and even move them wherever she wants.
After beating or wounding an opponent, she devours them with her jaws on Bogarl's sides, which she can increase and even eat large foes too.
She can also teleport away from opponents' attacks, and she can mold her skin to escape danger.
After absorbing electricity, she mutates into Bogarlmon. And if you think regular Bogarl is bad, why don't you meet Bogarlmon, who is much bigger and more dangerous than normal Bogarl.
While she still has some of her old abilities like increasing her tail, predatory behavior, and teleportation, but she can also fire electric bullets from her yellow orbs on her head spikes.
She can create electric whips to whip her foes.
She can also fly, and after consuming a monster, Bogarlmon's body heat will increase, and if she is destroyed, she will cause a massive explosion.
However, Bogarl does have some flaws.
She is very weak to electricity, being exposed can paralyze her. However, it is revealed that she can mutate it. But, and if an opponent is, can still escape her if her opponent is not wounded.
Despite all the faults she has still proven to be a much danger threat to all other monsters and other Ultramen. She almost defeated Ultraman Mebius, and she devoured Gudon and Twin Tail at the exact same time. Well, not really, but like, she defeated both of them at the exact same time and devoured them at once. So pretty much, you'll have the right to pee yourself if you encounter her. Alright, the fighters are set, let's settle this debate, but first, let's check out the prediction votes. 89% for Orga and 11% for Bogarl. Well, let's see if they're right or wrong, let the battle begin.
Man, talk about a full course meal. Anyway, why did Bogarl win? Now, Orga did have a couple advantages. He was a bit bigger, had regeneration, could gain Bogarl's DNA, his greater jumping distance could counter Bogarl's flight, and with the help of his UFO, it would give Bogarl quite a challenge, but Bogarl had everything she needs to take the win.
As far as strength goes, Orga can knock down Godzilla 2000, who weighs around 25,000 tons, but Bogarl is able to knock down Gudon, who also weighs 25,000 tons. But here's the thing though, Bogarl was able to do that while holding Twin Tail with her tail. I mean, doesn't that take like a lot of strength? So when it comes to strength, it feels like Bogarl might have the advantage.
She was also faster too, keeping up with Ultramans, not to mention a much better and more experienced fighter,
fighting a large variety of monsters. And while Orga can't gain Bogarl's DNA, that requires a getting up close and trying to bite Bogarl, which might be impossible due to Bogarl's abilities.
And while Orga can gain access to his UFO, Bogarl has experience on fighting two opponents at the exact same time, so this won't be any trouble for Bogarl. Not to mention she has better range and defense against Orga and has counters.
She can use her teleportation to avoid Orga's shoulder cannon and use it to avoid Orga eating her.
She can use her long tail to fight off the UFO.
She can use her energy blast on her back if Orga tries any sneak attacks.
And if Orga does, however, end up trying to eat Bogarl, or if the UFO tries to wrap Bogarl up with the Divines, Bogarl can use her skin mold to even escape it.
Also, Orga has no defense over Bogarl's psychic abilities, and while Orga can regenerate, it's not really perfect. Not to mention he cannot regenerate his shoulder cannon once it got destroyed, so once Bogarl got rid of the shoulder cannon, Orga has little means of having a chance of beating Bogarl.
She is also a faster eater too, and I know you guys are going to say that Orga's too big for Bogarl to eat. Bogarl has eaten larger foes before, so it's not going to be like anything of a challenge for Bogarl.
And when Bogarl reaches into her Bogarlmon form, it's basically all over for Orga, since considering that Bogarlmon is much bigger than Orga, and she would have no trouble of eating consuming Orga. But due to
Bogarl's numerous advantages, she has better chances of winning even without going into Bogarlmon form. Orga was definitely not going to give out without a fight, but due to Bogarl's strength, speed, abilities, and counters, and being a better eater, she has enough chance of defeating the Godzilla clone and consuming him.
I guess we could say that this is all over for the Godzilla clone. The winner is Bogarl. Now, before I show the next time, I have a lot of explaining to do. Now, let's start with the biggest question. Where in the hell have I been for the past 11 months? Now, let's get to the first question. Well, you see, the problem was because, like, I was kind of having a hard time with animation for Orga versus Bogarl. I was thinking of doing stick knots, but I'm not really that best at making stick knot figures, and Bogarl didn't have any stick knot figures, so I thought I could just hire someone, but I don't really know anyone who else would, like, do stick knots. I did ask one of my friends, but he was kind of busy, and I probably understand that. Also, I was also busy animating for other versus shows as well, and not to mention I was also busy with schoolwork, but now that I'm back, I can finally go back to doing fish wars, and I promise I will never take this long ever again. Okay, I'm not sure if I'm going to promise that, but I'll try not to take this long ever again. Also, if you guys are wondering, am I going to do Yoku vs. Megi? No. Okay, I mean, I do like the matchup and all, but just that I was kind of having a little hard time with the animation, and research was a little complicated. Also, and I actually my gut's kind of telling me not to make it for some reason. I just don't know why. Also, I feel like I should just get Orga vs. Bogarl done first, considering that I promised everyone I would make this fight, but also, another thing is, well, this might sound a little hard, but this is going to be my last season of Fiction Fires. It's just that I just kind of want to do other things, but don't worry. There will not be 10 episodes left. There's going to be, like, 18 episodes left. There are going to be fights that I really want to make for Fiction Fires, and it's going to be worth it. They're going to be all good. Also, I'm not really sure I'm going to do Ruby's Mask or Phantasy's episode for Season 5, considering that they're not really fights I really want to make. But I am going to do Dracula's episode. It's a fight I do want to make. So I'm back now, and I promise I will never take this long ever again. Okay, I should not promise that, but anyway, let's just get to the next time.